يَفْهَهُ قَوْلِي. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about this reality, the reality that we see with our own eyes, but we need to see it by our own heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described this reality as musiba. In Urdu, musiba. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَأَصَابَتْكُمْ مُصِيبَةِ الْمَوْتِ. You have been overcome with the tragedy of death. If you think about it, looking at those deceased, رحمهم الله, may Allah shower them with mercy, and you look at this tragedy, is there any tragedy bigger than the tragedy of death? Could you imagine any tragedy bigger than the tragedy of death? The answer, yes. The tragedy of forgetting about death, the tragedy of not preparing for death, the tragedy of running away from death. قُلْ إِنَّ الْمَوْتَ الَّذِي تَفُرُّونَ مِنْهُ فَإِنَّهُ مُلَاقِيكُمْ. Say that death you are running away from, it's gonna seize you. Preparation for death, it is a serious matter, because each and every one of us talking, walking, moving, breathing, each and every one of us in this queue, in this lineup, our turn would come sooner or later. Our ticket confirmed before our birth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed us this in the Holy Quran by saying, كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ. Every soul shall have the taste of death. وَإِنَّمَا تُوَفَّوْنَ أُجُورَكُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازَ. Every soul, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala confirming, affirming, and pinpointing that each and every one of us will have the taste of death. What kind of a taste? You tasted mango, you tasted all type of food, all type of fruits. What type of a taste death going to be? Is it a taste with La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Is it a wonderful taste? Whoever says La ilaha illallah, whoever the last of their word, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Man kana akhir kalamah La ilaha illallah dakhal al-jannah. Whoever the last of their word, La ilaha illallah, will enter Jannah. Is it gonna be a taste with La ilaha illallah? Or a terrible taste? Is it gonna be a taste that the angels, the malaika, honorable angels welcoming you? And Allah said, whoever removed from the hellfire, admitted into the Jannah, they succeeded. Success, my dear brothers and sisters, you will never have the taste, never have a good taste, and never have success unless you have the taste of Iman and the success of this dunya. By default, you will have the success in the grave and in the hereafter. Dear brothers and sisters, this is a dad. I spent time with him in the hospital. I saw him breathing. And this is a wonderful mom, grandmother, you name it. Now we think that they are gone, but the kindness for them has no expiry date, called birr al-walidain. Birr al-walidain does not end at death. No, it's ongoing. Birr al-walidain, being kind to mom and dad, making dua on their behalf, reading the Quran that they taught you, making donation, smart donation, not smart telephone only and a smart TV, smart donation. Every time you do anything good, say, on behalf of my mom and dad, on behalf of my loved ones. So this was smart donation, it includes everyone. So realize that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that your Lord decreed that you worship none but Him and kindness with parents. That means the only humongous purpose of our creation, worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is shoulder to shoulder with kindness to mom and dad. Has no expiry day. تَزَوَّدْ مِنَ التَّقْوَى فَإِنَّكَ لَا تَدْرِي إِذَا جَنَّ لَيْلٌ هَلْ تَعِشْ إِلَى الْفَجْرِ فَكَمْ مِنْ فَتَى أَمْسَى وَأَصْبَحَ ضَاحِكًا وَقَدْ نُسِجَتْ أَكْفَانَهُ وَهُوَ لَا يَدْرِي وَكَمْ مِنْ صِغَارٍ يُرْتَجَى طُولَ عُمْرِهِمْ وَقَدْ أُدْخِلَتْ أَجْسَامُهُمْ ظُلْمَةَ الْقَبْرِ وَكَمْ مِنْ صَحِيحٍ مَاتَ مِنْ غَيْرِ عِلَّةٍ وَكَمْ مِنْ سَقِيمٍ عَاشَ حِينًا مِنَ الدَّهْرِ وَكَمْ مِنْ عَرُوسٍ زَيَّنُوهَا لِزَوْجِهَا وَقَدْ قُبِضَتْ أَرْوَاحُهُمْ لَيْلَةَ الْقَدْرِ. The poet is telling us about a reality. Increase your taqwa. You never know if you live Isha time that you could reach Fajr time. How many youth, day and night, they are ready, their coffin is ready. They are playing, they're jolly, but their coffin ready, for them to hug them, and they don't know how many babies we look at them and we aim for their long life. Soon their grave, they enter the darkness of the grave. And how many brides, they anointed her, they decorated her, they made her look good for her husband, both of their soul collected in their wedding night. How many healthy people dropped dead? How many ill people lived a long while? So realize also a reality we're going to witness right now. All of us, we're going to witness this reality that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam spoke about. يَتْبَعْ الْمَيِّتِ ثَلَاثَ فَيَرْجِعْ إِثْنَانِ وَيَبْقَى وَاحِدٍ. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the deceased person will be followed by three. By three. Two will go back, one would stay with him. And that means one would stay with her. The family and the wealth and the deeds, they will follow. The family and the wealth will go back. The deeds will stay in the grave. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it a garden from heaven. Realize, my dear brothers and sisters, Allahumma ameen, that for you to attend the janazah, nothing's free. The deceased can't come and pay you. Allah pays us. Wallahi, if we know the humongous reward of the janazah, you'll be lining up outside every masjid to participate in the janazah. According to hadith narrated in Bukhari and Muslim, that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us, if you perform the salatul janazah, you will have one qirat. And then if you go follow the janazah, and this following for the male, for the brothers, the sisters could come after. Following the janazah, till it's buried, you will get two qirat. And they said, O Prophet of Allah, what's the qirat? He said, like the great mountain, which is in another narration, as big as the mountain of Uhud. Mountain of Uhud of reward, humongous reward. Don't miss any janazah. And the janazah for us is not just a salah. It's in reality we are coming to Allah, begging Allah to forgive them and to relieve them, to accept them, to give them stability, thabat fi deen, and to make their grave garden from heaven. This is the janazah. The final thing I would like to say, since we are walking and talking, since we have the chance and choice right now, think about planting everyday good deeds. Don't worry about cultivation. Don't worry about accumulation. Allah would accumulate and calculate your good deeds. Every day we need to plant. Wallahi, every single day we need to plant, and you are guaranteed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَلَنُحْيَنَّهُ حَيَاةً طَيِّبًا. Allah said that in the Holy Quran, we shall grant him a good life. If Allah give you a good life in this dunya, you are guaranteed a garden from heaven in your grave, and you are guaranteed the Jannah. Allahumma aghfir lahum warhamhum. Allahumma aghfir lahum warhamhum. Allahumma aghfir lahum warhamhum. Allahumma thabbithum. Allahumma thabbithum. Allahumma thabbithum ya rabbal alameen. Allahumma amilhum bima anta ahlun lah, ya ahl al-taqwa, ahl al-maghfira. Allahumma abdilhum daran khayra min darihim, wa ahlan khayra min ahlihim. Allahumma ja'al quburahum rawdatan min riyad al-jannah. اللهم ارحمنا إذا صرنا إلى ما صاروا إليه. اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات. اللهم اسألك أن تجمعنا أحبابنا الفردوس الأعلى غير سابق عذاب. آمين. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد. جزاكم الله خير. You could give a quick condolences, ta'ziyah to the families of both deceased.
Welcome to this new episode on the go with this reality. This is Sanduq al-Amal. This is the residence that you will enter for Hayat al-Barzakh. So this way, each and every one of us, come look at your residence. Each and every one of us will be in this residence. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, kullu nafsin dha'iqat al-maut. Every soul shall have the taste of death. So this is our grave. Make sure every day you plant. Every day tazra, and the cultivation, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would accumulate and calculate what you plant, and realize that in this grave the most people who love you, they will just dump the sand on you and then leave you alone. As Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, that the deceased person would be followed by three: ahlahu wa malahu amalah, the family and the deeds. That me and you, our ticket ready confirmed before our birth to be in this hall, to be in this, inshallah, garden from heaven. Realize that in this dunya, all of us in this lineup, our ticket confirmed before our birth, and our turn will come sooner than later. قل إن الموت الذي تفرون منه فإنه ملاقيكم. Say death, that the one that you are running away from is going to seize you. Look at that. Look at the loneliness. Look at the loneliness. Look at those who are reading the Quran. The Quran would be their companion in the grave. Look at those who are sponsoring an orphan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make their life in this dunya حياةً طيبة. Allah promised in the Holy Quran, those who are doing good deeds, فَلَنُحْيَنَّهُ حَيَاةً طَيِّبًا. We shall grant them a good life. My dear brothers and sisters, this reality, all of us, we forget. Or most likely we attend so many janazah. But do we ponder? Do we meditate? Do we make tadabbur over this reality? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala soften our hearts to realize that sooner than later, we will enter this grave. And when your mom and dad enters this grave, the birrul walidain, kindness to parents, does not expire, does not have an expiry date. You can do so many good deeds on their behalf. If you want the final thing to be remembered with your closet at home, if you tell people at home that you're going into the closet and try to lie down in the closet, close the closet, let people know that you are in the closet, feel the loneliness, feel what does it mean to be in the grave. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower us with His mercy and send so much salawat upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Assalamu alaikum.